Good morning, one and all. Today I will explain you about variable in C++. Okay, how to declare the variable? Okay, what are the advantages of the variable? What are the importance of the variable? In last class, I talked about structure of the C++ program. By using the structure, I wrote the simple program. Okay, but if you want to write any program in C++, the important variable which plays important role. Okay, today I am going to explain about variable concept in C++. Okay, then what is variable? What is variable? Now, if you ask that question to the students, they will tell the answer: variable is used to store a data value. It is correct. Okay, what is the use of the variable? Is to store a data. But what is variable? Why should we use variable in our programming concept? Okay, you should tell me. Okay, then simply the variable is nothing but the name of the memory location. Okay, name of the memory location. Isn't it? Okay, why it is called the name of the memory location? I will tell you. Okay, I will explain with the help of the example. The next one is, okay, which is also called as reserve a space in a memory. Okay, how to reserve a space in a memory? Okay, based on data type. Okay, then I will tell you. Okay, then what is the use of a variable? Is store a data value. Store a data value. Okay, these are some of the definitions of variable concept, isn't it? Here today I will explain you what is the importance of the variable, what is the syntax of declaring the variable, how to initialize the variable, and also I will write the simple program by using the variable concept. Okay, then the name of the memory location, which also called reserve space in memory. Okay, what is the use of the variable? Is to store a data value. To store a data value. Okay, they are the variable definition. After that, what you have to do is how to declare the variable. Okay, I will write the syntax to declaring the variable is variable declaration. Variable declaration. Declaration and initialization also. Variable declaration and initialization. What is the syntax to declaring the variable in C++? Data type, then followed by the variable name, followed by the semicolon. Okay, what is the syntax to declaring the variable in C++? Data type, space, variable name. Okay, data type, for example, as per that syntax, I will declare the variable. Data type is the integer, then variable name. Okay, then amount, then followed by the syntax, semicolon. Int is the data type. What is the name of the variable? Is amount. Okay, what is the rules to declaring the variable? What are the rules to declaring the variable? Okay, whenever the variable is declared, the variable must satisfy all the rules of the identifier. Okay, which is called all the rules of identifier. Identifier is nothing but which refers to the name of the variable, name of the class, name of a function, or name of a array, whatever. Whenever you give the name of the variable, the variable should satisfy all the rules of the identifier. It is very, very important. Okay, but what are the rules of the identifier? I will tell you. The first one is, the identifier is a combination of alphabetic characters digits and underscore operator. Okay, combination of alphabetic character, comma, digits and underscore operator. The first one. The second rule is that the first letter of a identifier or first letter of a variable should not start with a digit. It must start with a alphabetic character or underscore. Generally, we don't use underscore operator as a first letter. Okay, we can use it, there is no problem. Okay, the first letter of your identifier starts with the alphabetic characters, but not by the digit. Not by what is the first letter? Alphabetic character. There is no problem. It is not a digit. Okay, the third rule is the keywords cannot be used as a identifiers. Keywords. Suppose int is a keyword. For example, keywords have the predefined meanings. Okay, which can't be used as identifiers. Okay, then for while, do, which are some keywords will be there. Okay, which has some predefined meanings. We don't use as a variable or array name or a class name or function name. Okay, don't use. Okay, then fourth one is special characters are not allowed. We don't use the special character as a variable name. Okay, isn't it? Here, the first one is a combination of alphabetic characters, digits, and underscore operator. Then second one is the first letter of the identifier start with the alphabetic characters but not start with a digit. Then third one is keywords cannot be used as identifiers or variable names. The fourth one, special characters are not allowed. The question mark, some symbols are there which are called as special characters. Okay, which can't be used as a variable name or identifiers. Isn't it? Okay, for example, the int amount, okay, which satisfies all the rules of the identifier. We check it once. Okay, it is a combination of alphabetic characters, underscore, and digits. Anyway, I used all our alphabetic characters. The first letter started with alphabetic characters. Okay, there is no keywords. There is no special characters. Okay, it is a valid variable declaration. Okay, once you done the declaration, what happens? Okay, then some space is reserved in a memory based on the data type. Generally, what is the variable name? Amount. Suppose 100 is an address. How much space is reserved, occupies, then based on the data type. Integer generally 2 bytes, which occupy 2 bytes of memory or 2 bytes of space in a memory. Okay, integer generally which occupy 2 bytes. Okay, the amount is a variable. Here, name of the memory location. Yes, it is exactly. Here, the variable is the name of the memory location. Okay, how do you retrieve the value from the memory? How do you retrieve the value from the memory with the help of the variable name? Yes, exactly. That's why the variable is nothing but the name of the memory location. Yes, here, look at this diagram. Whenever done the declaration of the variable, which reserves space in a memory, based on the data type, the variable name, there's some address location where the value will be stored in the memory at particular address location. For example, I have taken the 100 is the address location, how much space is reserved, then 2 bytes of memory which occupies by the variable. Yes? Yeah. Here, once done the variable declaration, behind of that, what happens? In the memory, some space will be reserved. What is the memory location? Is amount. Yes. Then another one, int 2a. What is the first letter? Digit. It is not a valid variable declaration. Okay. Int a2. Yeah, first letter is alphabetic character. It is a combination of alphabetic character and digits. It is valid. Yes. Yes or no?
Yes.
Okay. You should satisfy the all the rules of the identifiers. Okay. These are some examples. Suppose float. If you want to take the float. Suppose sales. Semicolon. Okay. Float is a data type. Okay. What is the memory? Name. Sales. Then how much? 4 bytes. Generally floats will occupy 4 bytes. Some address location is 200. Okay. It is an address. Don't confuse. Okay. If you initialize the float value. Okay. Then what happens? I will tell you after that. How to initialize the values. Okay. This is only how I told you declaration of the variables. Then data type. Variable name followed by the semicolon. You got it? Clear? Then after that, what you have to do? Once we done the declaration of the variable, you should initialize the value of your variable. Okay, how do you initialize the value of your variable? I will tell you. Okay? The variable is declared. Okay? Then how do you initialize the value? The variable name equal to initialization. Okay? The variable name is what? Amount. Amount equal to initialization. Suppose 10 followed by the semicolon. Okay? The amount equal to 10. What is the amount? It is the name of the variable or name of your memory location. Okay? If you initialize the value, it will be stored here. The amount, what is the value of amount? Amount value becomes 10. What is the syntax to initialize the value? The amount equal 10. Okay. Then floats. Suppose int. Suppose float. Sales. The sales. Generally float value which will be considered the decimal part. Okay. Sales equal. Suppose 10.25. Okay. Then here. Sales. 10.25, then how much bytes? 4 bytes. How much space which will occupy? 4 bytes for the variable sales. Suppose it is a 200 is an address. It is done the whenever declare the variable, which reserve a space for the variable name sales. Whenever initialize the value, okay, that will be stored in the variable sales. 10.25. Because What is the difference between int and float? Which will take the only integer values. Okay, does not take the decimal part. After the point value which will not be considered. In case of float, which will be considered the decimal part also. I will tell you later. The next video or next class, I will explain you about the data types. Different data types will be supported by the C++. At that time, I will discuss briefly. Okay? Now this is called as the variable declaration and variable initialization. Once variable is declared, after that you can initialize the value. The next step is that you can initialize the variable at the time of declaration. Okay? Listen carefully. Declare the variable, initialize the value of the variable at the time of the declaration. Okay? How you can do it? Okay? The syntax is that how do you initialize the variable at the time of declaration? Syntax is that data type variable name equal to initialization followed by the semicolon. Data type variable name equal to initialization. Here previously what we did, first we declare the variable, after that we initialize the value. Now, you can initialize the value of a variable at the time of declaring. Okay, then as per that syntax, int amount. Previously what we did, we did two statements. One statement for the declaring the variable, one statement for initializing the variable. Both statements are written in a single line. It is correct. the data type, the variable name is amount, then equal, then installation. What is the installation? The 10 is the installation. Int amount equal to 10. Or else float sales 10.26 whatever. Okay, the amount variable can hold the value 10. The variable sales can hold the values 10.26. Is it clear all of you? Okay, this is syntax to initialize the variable at the time of declaring the variable. Okay, yes, it is at the time of declaring the variable only I initialize the variable value. Yes, this is another, you can initialize the value of the variable at the time of declaration. I hope that it is clear everybody how the, what is variable, how to declare the variable, how to initialize the variable. Okay, I will write the simple program using the variable concept. Example. Then void main, int x, okay, int x comma y, then x initialized with 10, then y initialized with 20. Then if you want to display the x and value, then another, I want to declare the another variable c. C equal x plus y. Okay, then c out result equal then c. Yeah. How many variables I declare? X, Y, and C. And I will tell you, you can declare the variable. N number of variables can be declared in a single line. Okay, multiple variables can be declared in a single line. There is no problem. Okay. How many variables I declare? X, Y, C. Three variables I declare under the which data type? Integer. Okay. Then x is belongs to integer, y is belongs to integer, c is belongs to integer. You can differentiate the variable names followed by same comma operator. Sorry. Okay, the variable can be differentiated by comma operator. X, y, c. Okay, once we done the variable declaration, x is initialized with 10, y is initialized with 20. It is good. Then c is another variable. C equal x. What is the x value? 10. What is the y value? 20. Okay. Here 10 plus 20. What is the value? 30. Where the 30 will be stored? The 30 will be stored in the variable c. Now what is the value? C value becomes 30. Okay. Then c out. Then what is the output we get it from this example? C out. Then operator. The insertion operator, then the cout object which is used to display the output on the output device. Okay, result, whatever you write within the double quotes, it is belongs to the string constant. Okay, the same thing will be displayed on the output. Okay, result equal. Then c, what is the c value? What is the c value? 30. What is the output? The result is. Okay, in today's class, we learnt about variable concept in C++. Okay, thank you.